to say day 214. I haven't done a video since the 7th of September. Main reason being, not a lot's changed, to be fair. Still got my infection. Every time I think it's clearing up, it just seems to come back. On antibiotics again. I'm trying to, waiting for him to get sorted out now with the right antibiotics for the infection. I mean, it's been just under 11 weeks and it's still there. Haven't been back to hospital, which is a good thing. Voice is still croaky. Still tired. So there is, you know, there is still side effects going on. The good thing that has happened, to be fair, which is today, which is, well, yesterday now, there's no Tuesday, but Monday 23rd of October 2023, me and Chris went up to Shrewsbury Hospital for an appointment I had there, and they went through all the medical stuff, and as of yesterday, I'm cancer-free. So the chemo did its job. There was no cancer left in my bladder, even though my bladder was wrecked, and it had to come out. There was no cancer in it, so the chemo killed the cancer. There was no cancer in my prostate. There was no cancer in my lymph nodes, which, you know, were taken out and biopsied and checked. So the cancer hadn't spread any further. I mean, that's exceptionally good news. You know, it's been a long time. It's been 11 weeks of not knowing. And that's, it's like everything with this cancer thing. I mean, you've got to think now, this was, you know, 214 days ago this started, 22nd of March, and as much as I thought I'd be good with it and I'd be able to deal with it, I haven't dealt with it well, really, at all. You know, a lot of people are like, oh, you're looking well, it's an act, most of it. I mean, I don't feel great, but... You know, I don't want people to see me if I have to go somewhere to looking like shit. You know? So a lot of it is an act. I mean, I'm starting to see changes in me which aren't really the way. My biggest problem is now, and I've said this on other videos before, I don't feel like me anymore. There's a lot of me that's gone. The old me is gone. My sense of humour is still the same and things like that, but there's a lot of me that isn't there anymore. And I'm finding it harder to deal with than I thought I would. I don't really go out. I stay in the house as much as I can. To be fair, one of the reasons being as well is because these clots on my lungs are, as they said, noticeably larger. I don't want to get flu, I don't want a cold, I don't want COVID again at all, not with, you know, these clots on my lungs. So that's one of the reasons I don't see a lot of people, because I'm really concerned about picking something up. I was concerned before when I was on chemo, but I'm just as concerned now, and I don't want to get anything, you know. So it was a good day with that, you know. That was something that I've been waiting to hear for a while. We've been waiting to hear for a long time. And, you know, I don't think it's sunk in properly yet. I mean, the biggest thing I've noticed with me is, through all of this, I've hardly cried about it, you know. I don't know if that's because I'm scared of doing it. Because in case I do and I don't stop, I don't know. Or is it because it just hasn't sunk in? I don't know. I don't know. I mean, I'm off the fags still. Yeah, I'm on this, but this, for me, is better than fags by any stretch. Trying to think what else happened in since my last video. One of the another thing that happened, which I promised I was going to do, was I managed to walk my daughter Amy down the aisle to marry her fiance Jay. That was a good day. That really was. I mean, the fact that I managed to take her down the aisle because right up until a couple of days before that was really in doubt. The infection was getting worse. I felt as rough as hell through the infection. It was so up in arms if I was going to go. But, you know, I promised her I'd walk her down the aisle. And I wasn't some old bloody half-dead looking bloke either. So that was great, you know, that was so nice. I mean, obviously for me, but obviously especially for her and Jay. You know, that was a big, big thing for all of us. Emotional day, as to be expected. But I think it was a bit more heightened emotion that day as well. Because I don't know what she'd have been like if I hadn't gone. But I did go, so, you know, doesn't matter with that now, I was there. Speaking to my urology nurse today, I definitely need counselling. I need somebody to talk to. The trouble is, I mean, I know one person who is a friend as well, which is very odd, who's having the same problem. You know, he's had bladder cancer. He's had everything removed that I've had removed. He's been taken back into hospital with infections. I think it's the same as mine, but he's got other problems as well. But, you know, he's somebody I can probably talk to about it because he'd understand. But it's very difficult to sort of explain to people how you feel when it's really difficult to convey how, you know, what it's like. But, you know, again, I'll get help and see what that does, to be honest. I mean, there's still, I think, a massive amount of depression going on with me. Which, you know, again, there's, with everything that we've been through, it's not surprising, to be fair. It's, you know, it's not just a physical toll with all chemo and the operation and recovery and all that. It's not just the physical, it's the mental side as well. So, you know, it's going to take a while. But I'll get there in the end. Again, thank you everybody that posted today about, posted on Facebook about being cancer free today. And that was, yeah, well, that blew up that day. It was brilliant. All I still want with this is, and as I said this from the beginning, this is a video where I want people to go and get themselves checked out over things. Don't, you know, don't ignore it. Don't pretend it's brilliant, you know, everything's good. Don't brush it under the carpet. Just please go and get something done, because otherwise you'll have the same shit that I've been through with me and my family and my friends. And it's not nice. There's nothing nice about any of it. I mean, it's been just under 11 weeks, be 11 weeks on Wednesday, since my op. The stoma side of things, I can look after that okay. But at the minute, I'm not really looking after it. It's a district nurse's because I'm having to get it changed daily because of the infection. I've seen my stoma nurse and she was very happy with the way it looks and the way it's working and stuff, but I hate it. There's days where I can't even look at that bag. I absolutely fucking hate it. I really do. Really, really hate it. But what were my options? There wasn't really any option. It's either have that or be dead, and a lot quicker than I planned to be dead. So that's something, again, that psychologically I've got to get used to. Because it's just there all the time. And when I was talking to my stoma nurse, like, I knew about hernias, but I didn't realise how high the risk is of hernias, especially where the stoma is. Because the muscles, say that was a stoma, you've got muscle there. And if you do something, you've got real high chance of just pushing up. And the muscle will coming through. So I don't want to hear you. You know, I don't think anybody want to hear any, even people with them, you know, they don't want them. So I've got to be careful with that. But I'm still waiting to get into Stoke to get this IVC filter removed from my plug cloths, but my nurse today said that they may not take it out yet because I have still got big cloths, so again, we'll wait and see with that, we'll see what happens. All I know with that is it'll be coming out of here. They put it in my groin, but it'll be coming out of my neck because it's got like a hook on it, and the only way, obviously, the hook's on the top is to go down through my artery and then into whatever it is in my body to pull out. But again, we'll see with that when it happens. So at the moment, that's what's been going on. Obviously, the best news today was being told I'm cancer-free, which is a huge relief, to be honest. I mean, I didn't want to do chemo again, but if I had to do it, I would have, because, you know, that just needs to be done. So that was a good day today with that. You know, that was some really good news. It's like I say, I don't really think it's sunk in properly yet. There's this, I don't know, it's like a wall blocking a lot of the emotions off, and I don't know why. Because I'm usually quite an emotional person, but I don't know why this isn't coming out. It'll come out eventually. You know, maybe with this, I don't know, therapy, talking like with other people, maybe it'll come out then. But we'll see with them. So obviously, again, if you can, you know, like, share, subscribe. Try to, you know, get out to as many people as possible so they haven't got to go through any of this stuff. Obviously now, living with cancer is going to be change now, I suppose. I don't know what to put it as. Surviving cancer. Living after cancer, maybe. I'll find a title. I mean, today will be the Living with Cancer. There'll be the last one of those, and then I'll change the title to whatever, but we'll still carry on the days. So again, thank you everybody for watching. Thank you everybody for liking, subscribing and sharing, and I'll catch you all soon. Thank you.